Wisconsin's historic recall election heads into the home stretch. Today on Upfront, the campaign strategy in these final days, the parts of the state to watch on Tuesday, and just how close could this election be? It's all this week on Upfront.
Honest, candid, insightful. This is Upfront with Mike Gouchet.
Hello again, everyone, and welcome to Upfront. Well, it's almost here. The eyes of the nation will be on Wisconsin Tuesday for the recall election for Republican Governor Scott Walker, Lieutenant Governor Rebecca Clayfish, and four state Senate seats. Walker and his Democratic challenger, Milwaukee Mayor Tom Barrett, aren't letting up in these final few days. Two met for their final debate Thursday night at Marquette University Law School. And on Friday, each brought in a star from their own party. Former President Bill Clinton for Barrett, South Carolina Governor Nikki Haley for Walker. We'll have several angles on the election today, and we begin with two respected campaign strategists. Mark Graul is a Republican with Arena Strategies in Green Bay. He ran Mark Green's 2006 campaign for governor. Paul Maslin is a Democratic pollster who recently worked for former candidate for governor Kathleen Falk. Thanks to both of you for being with us today.
Thank you. Good to be here.
Let's get your assessment of the race in these final hours. How do you think it stands right now, Paul Maslin?
I think it's closer than the public polls suggest. I think the private polls I've been hearing about say that the governor may have a lead, but the lead is very small, maybe a point or two at most. I think turnout next Tuesday is still a big indicator. One feeling I've had all along about this race is that if it were only the 2010 electorate doing a redo, that Walker would certainly prevail, but it's not going to be. There are going to be several hundreds of thousands, probably, of voters who voted in 2008, did not vote in 2010. Many of them signed recall petitions. They're going to be back in the process. How many of them turn out, what the actual share is for Barrett over Walker, could tell the story here. It's going to be still a close election, I believe.
Do you agree with that assessment, close election?
Yeah, absolutely, it's going to be a close election. And I think over the next, the final few days here, whichever side is more effective in contacting voters, knocking on doors, making phone calls, getting people to the polls, that side's going to win. It's definitely a very close election. And whatever these public polls are saying, I think everybody needs to know it's going to be an incredibly close election. So folks who care about this need to vote and grab some friends, too.
As two people who have worked on many campaigns, in this race, it's so different because it is a recall election. We really don't know about turnout. That would, I imagine, be something that would keep you up every night if you were running, for example, the governor's campaign.
Yeah, it's impossible to predict who's all going to show up. So that's why you want to, you know, there's... In today's day and age of targeting and micro-targeting, campaigns are better equipped to try to zero in on their voters and take tactics necessary to get them to the polls, whether that's a door knock or a phone call or a piece of mail or a TV ad. You can be pretty precise on it. So if I were running one of these campaigns, I'd do everything I can to get as many of those folks who I think are going to vote for my candidate to the polls, however you can do it.
And remember, you know, we had not too distant in our past, we had two elections for president, 2000 and 2004, in which you could argue both sides were totally mobilized and produced a tremendous turnout on each side of those elections, as this one is, without really a bias one way or the other. And those elections came down within 11, both of them within 11,000 votes. So we may actually, hate to say this, but late Tuesday night, we may not know the answer to this,
Don't say the R word. Don't say recount. I'm not sure the state's ready for that right now.
Waukesha County, here we come.
Let's talk for a moment about the messaging in these final hours of the campaign. It seems like the Barrett campaign, Paul Maslin, has really begun to focus hard on the John Doe. That has become really the primary talking point of the campaign right now. Would you not agree?
I think there's a question of trust, and I think it's a legitimate question of trust. I think you saw in the debate last night, the governor really doesn't have a particularly compelling answer. He's trying to make us believe that he was like Woodward and Bernstein in Deep Throat, ferreting out this problem, when in fact now the truth seems to indicate that it was much more the opposite. There was stonewalling going on. And I think the other question, I'm going to credit Scott Walker here for a second. I think two things came out of that debate last night. One was the fact that Barrett essentially saying to the voters of Wisconsin, you know, beware here. What's really going to happen? What's going to happen after this election? What could still happen on this case? Why does he have a criminal defense fund? We've had indictments of people very close to him. What is still going, could transpire after the election is over? And the governor's last words last night about why he should be reelected was, in essence, he said, you better reelect me, because if you don't, we're going to keep having recalls. To me, that was kind of a veiled threat, which is our side's not going to quit here. We're going to keep doing this. And I think there was a troubling aspect of that for if I'm still that last voter in the middle about, wait a minute, what am I getting here if I keep this guy in office?
I'll let you address the messaging and what he just said.
Well, I think what's troubling is that we have a recall that was supposedly started over collective bargaining reforms that now all sides, I think, agree have worked well. It's saved the taxpayers $1 billion. We've got we got rid of a $3.6 billion deficit without raising taxes. We've got job growth in the state. So allegedly, this recall was about collective bargaining. And now the Barrett campaign and the Democrats are trying to throw a red herring of some John Doe investigation that is full of rumor and innuendo, where the governor has frankly been incredibly forthright about it, been incredibly open about what is going on in that investigation. Frankly, said more than I think a lot of people said he should, because he's trying so hard to be such an open book about it. But really what this election, this recall election, was supposed to be about was, are the reforms that the governor implemented working? And the answer very clearly is yes, they are. So the Democrats and the Barrett campaign have tried to change the subject, but I don't think that's going to work.
Do you think the debates change anything at all in this election?
Ordinarily, and these debates are much more akin to a national campaign, because we actually have had an audience. You know, a lot of times you have a debate and nobody really watches the debate, they just see the newscasts. But you've actually had an audience for your debate last night and the debate last week. A lot of times debates sort of serve to sort of motivate and intensify each side. So that I watch a debate, I agree with Scott Walker or Tom Barrett, and I'm confirmed in my view, and I'm now even more motivated to vote. And they have less of an impact on the true middle, which we all understand and we could agree is very small in this election. I'm going to say, though, that at least last night I saw a little spark that made me wonder. You know, politics is not like a basketball game. I think Scott Walker would love to run out the clock right now. So we've all been in elections, good or bad for each of us, where things turn in those last 3 or 4 days. It's much more like a baseball game where you have to get the final out. And I'm not sure that you still couldn't have a shift of opinion.
Let me ask you each for some perspective here. You were a pollster for Gray Davis in 2003 when he lost the recall election. You ran Mark Green's campaign, which was unsuccessful. Mm-hmm. I want to get your thoughts on this. Were there any lessons to be learned from the Gray Davis experience?
Don't run against Arnold Schwarzenegger, number one. The biggest thing, though, whatever similarities occurred between the two were sort of in the run-up and last year and the whole sort of initiative, the sort of collection of signatures and that process. The elections themselves are totally different. And I won't bore the audience with all the reasons, but very different kind of election, very different premise for that election. This is a case where both bases are very motivated and very energized, and it's close. That was a case where, for whatever set of reasons, Gray Davis's base over time had eroded, and people looked for an alternative. So from that standpoint, it is a very different election this time, and I don't know if you can really draw any particular lessons.
If you could share any of your experience with the Walker folks in these final hours, was there a lesson to be learned from the 2006 experience?
Well, the problem in 2006 was, you know, the lesson to be learned is don't be a Republican in 2006, and certainly don't be a Republican who has any connection to George W. Bush. So it really is, I agree with Paul, it's hard to draw analogies. We have, for the first time really in our state since 2004, we have a kind of an even electorate. Winds aren't blowing one way or another, so that's why the turnout is really going to matter. That's why it's going to be so important for Walker supporters and Barrett supporters to do all they can over the last 3 days to really get that vote out, because that's what's going to matter the most. And it's what we saw in 2004, too.
Yeah. Democratic pollster Paul Maslin, Republican strategist Mark Graul. Good to have you both with us today.
Thanks.
Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Next, what insiders are saying about the elections and the campaigns. We'll be talking to John Nichols of the Cap Times and The Nation and Brian Schimming, the vice chair of the Republican Party, when Upfront continues.
Upfront with Mike Boucher, brought to you by American Transmission Company.